I mean, everyone has different voices, you know, and everyone has different fingerprints. It's just the same how you play, you know. For me, the most challenging thing was that the concerto itself is almost 40 minutes long, and from the beginning until the end, it just needs, you know, like full energy. Unlike other famous concertos like Tchaikovsky or Sibelius, I mean, Carl Nielsen concerto is not really known, which is a big pity. You know, how I made it sound special was just, you know, to be really convincing about my own interpretation about it, you know, because when you're not confident, you know, with what you're doing or what you're trying to express, then no matter what you do, it's not convincing. There's no permanent winner. Oh, it's always changing. Maybe some people, they play, you know, good on this competition, but then the other competition, maybe they have a bad day. Just to judge yourself only with the result, it's not a good way to approach it. So I think the best advice would be just do your best and don't let the result disappoint you. Well, I have a lot. I mean, I like Heifetz, Oistrakh, and everybody likes them. But the most inspiring violinist I've ever met is, of course, my teacher, my current teacher, Kolya Blacher. Every lesson, he is so strict. I mean, I barely had compliments from him. And I'm not complaining because that's what really made me strong. I would like to be a surgeon. I like doing something with my hands. That was always my biggest interest, like, you know, I mean, still, now I watch a lot of, you know, surgical videos on YouTube. I think human body is very, very interesting. It's like, almost like a miracle, actually. And, you know, as a performer, also, like, you know, how my body works, like, you know, depends on my condition or how I should be maintaining my health. I'm also, in a way, trying to figure out how I should be making difference, you know. I don't particularly want to, you know, like, you know, wear short dresses or like wear high heels or something like that. I mean, everyone has different voices, you know, and everyone has different fingerprints. It's just the same how you play, you know. It's just very different, and probably, you know, you will have to know exactly how to really maximize, you know, the pros you have, you know, like, and also minimize the cons, you know, you have. Well, I just started in an orchestra in Berlin as a concertmaster since this September. The orchestra is called Staatskapelle Berlin, and it's an orchestra directed by Daniel Barenboim. You know, it was very interesting. At first, I never really imagined myself being an orchestra musician. But I think, you know, we are living in 2017 now, and, you know, there is no rule that you just have to be one, you know, like, concert soloist. It's also good to have, you know, good to see and look around what's next to you and which, you know, road you can take. So at this moment, I'm trying out many things, many new things, and I'm having many new experiences and learning a lot from, you know, different people. I listen to many Paco de Lucia, flamenco guitar, and I listen to a lot of jazz as well sometimes with Ella Fitzgerald. I mean, no, people usually they listen to classical music to relax, but I can never relax when I listen to classical music. It's just, you know, even like a very simple Mozart piano sonata, it's just, you know, when I listen to it, I just have to stop doing things and then I have to just listen to it, you know? It's never really like a background music for me.